Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part one of how to find the greatest common factor of two or more numbers. So in this video, we explain what the greatest common factor means, and we show a quick, fun, easy way to find the greatest common factor, and we do these three problems on this video. I'm going to show you an easy way to find the greatest common factor of two or more numbers. First of all, the greatest common factor has this abbreviation GCF. So when you see GCF, it's referring to the greatest common factor. Before showing you the easy way to do this, I'm just explain what greatest common factor refers to. Let's say I said find the greatest common factor of 8 and 12. So basically, I need to find factors of 12, right? Then I have to figure out which ones they have in common. And then I have to find the greatest one, right? The greatest in common, describes what kind of factors. So let's just write down the factors of 8 and the factors of 12. So the factors of 8, you just think what numbers go into 8? 1 goes into 8, 2 goes into 8, 4 goes into 8, and 8 goes into 8. In other words, what number divides evenly into 8? And 12, what are the factors? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. On another video, I show you how to easily get all the factors. But for now, these are the factors of 8 and the factors of 12. So, we found the factor of each of those. I want the common factor. Okay, what are the common factors? In other words, what are factors of both 8 and 12? Well, I see I have a 1 in each of them, a 2 in each of them, and a 4 in each of them. So my common factors are 1, 2, and 4. So the greatest common factor of 8 and 12 is the biggest one right here, 4. Now, we don't want to go through all this to find out the greatest common factor of 8 and 12. But what we're looking for is the biggest number that divides evenly into both 8 and 12. So now I'm going to show you an easy way to get that. All right, here it is. This is going to be easy for this first one. Find the greatest common factor of 8 and 12. What you're going to do is put the two numbers next to each other with a little space in between, and we're going to do a little upside down division. So I'm going to do an upside down division bar. And I'm going to think of any number that goes into both 8 and 12, except the number 1. We know 1 goes into everything. That's kind of boring. So you really want to try to think of the biggest number you could think of that goes into it. All right. And so some people are going to get it right away. They're going to say it's 4. And let's just do the division. 4 goes into 8 is 2. And 4 goes into 12 three times. And then you look at your new numbers and you say, is there any other number besides 1 that goes into those? And there is not. So over here is the greatest common factor. Well, of course, that's if you could just figure it out quickly. But some people might not think of 4. So maybe what they did was say, I can't think of any number that goes into 8 and 12. So here's what you do. You start off with the first prime numbers. So first prime number. Remember the primes? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. These are etc. These go on forever and ever. But here's the first few prime numbers. These are numbers that the only number that divides into them are 1 and itself. Okay, so you start off with the first prime number. If you can't think of anything, and you say, does that go into it? Well, the first prime number is 2. Does 2 go in to both of these numbers? And if it does, you put it out in front and divide. So 2 goes into 8 four times, and 2 goes into 12 six times. And then you try the same number again to see if it happens to work. All right, so we're going to try 2 again. Does 2 go into 4 and 6? Yes. So we put another division bar and we do it again. 2 goes into 4 twice, and 2 goes into 6 three times. This was a kind of easy one. We stop when we get to two numbers that Nothing goes into except 1. Okay, so what you do is you multiply the numbers here on the left-hand side. So 2 times 2 equals 4, and that's the greatest common factor of 8 and 12. Now, this is a fairly easy problem, but it works for more than two numbers and it works for large numbers. So let's do a little more interesting example. All right, let's find the greatest common factor of 75 and 90. So you're looking for the biggest factor or divisor, that's another word, of 75 and 90. What number goes into that? The largest one. So we just do 75 and 90 under this end of under here. And so first of all, some of you might know what that is and you might just put that number there, but let's say you're looking at it and you just don't know where to get started. So again, think of the prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, 7 is 1 and then 11, etc. So you look and see if you can't think of a number that goes into both of them, just start with the first prime number and see if it goes into it. Now, when I look at 75 and 90, this is what I see. I see a number that 5 goes into it. Did you notice that? Because one ends in 5 and one ends in 0. So any number that ends in a 5 or 0 can be divided by 5. So I'm going to choose 5, okay? This is how somebody might do it. They think, oh, 5 goes into it. So then we divide. 5 goes into 75. All right, so we have to do the arithmetic. 5 goes into 7, 1, 2, that's going to be 15. And then I have to say, how many times does 5 go into 90? You might go in a piece of scratch paper and do your division. I also have a video showing you how to divide by 90 the easy way. And anyway, you're going to get 18 if you divide. Or you get a calculator and do 90 divided by 5. All right, now we're looking at 15 and 18, and I'm thinking, okay, what's a number that goes into 15 and 18? Okay, so again, somebody might figure that out in their head, but if not, you could start with the first prime number. Does 2 go into both those numbers? And no, because they're not both even. So the next prime number is 3. Does 3 go into both of these numbers? Yes. So let's go ahead and divide by 3. So we're going to put it upside down, division bar. We get 5 and 6. All right. So now we've got 5 and 6. Is there any number besides 1 that goes into 5 and 6? No. I'm going to give you a little secret, by the way. If you have any two consecutive integers, like 5 and 6, or 9 and 10, or 15 and 16, there's no number except one that goes into them. You'll learn that later, later, later about why that's true, but for now, it's kind of an interesting little factoid. So the greatest common factor is 5 times 3. You multiply those numbers. So the answer is 15. You do 3 times 5 to get that. Okay. Now, how might somebody else have done this problem? Same exact problem. Let me make this a little bit smaller so we have more space on our page. Okay, so there's the problem the first time I did it. Let's do it again. Because the cool thing about this is you don't have to, everybody does it a little bit differently. So let's say you didn't notice 5 went into those numbers. All right, you just had no clue. What goes into 75 and 90? No idea. So you start with the first prime number. Does 2 go into both of these numbers? And the answer is no. 2 does not go into it because 75 is even. So we'll take the next prime number, 3, and we'll say, does 3 go into both of these numbers? And actually, find out if it goes into it. If you're not sure, divide it. There's an easy way to tell if 3 goes into any number. You just add the digits and see if 3 goes into it. So 3 does go into 75, and it also goes into 90. 3 goes into 75 25 times. 3 goes into 90 30 times. Okay? Now we'd already checked 2, so we're on to 3. Does 3 go into these two numbers? No, because 3 does not go into 25. So we'll take the next prime number. The next prime number is 5. Does 5 go into both of these numbers? Yes. So we divide. 5 into 25 is 5, and 5 into 30 is 6. And again, nothing except 1 goes into it. Once you get an, if nothing goes into it except 1, you're done. You're going to multiply If there's more than one number, you're going to multiply those numbers together. So we still are going to multiply 3 times 5, and we'll still get the greatest common factor of 15. Let's do one where we have three numbers. All right, find the greatest common factor of 12, 18, and 30. All right, so we're just going to put all three numbers next to each other with a little space, and we're going to do this upside down division bar. And we're going to think, what number goes into all three numbers? Okay, well, some of you might just come up with it off the top of your head, or you could start with the first prime number, which happens to be 2. So does 2 go into all these numbers? They're even, so the answer is yes. So we divide 2 into it. Into 12 is 6. 2 goes into 18 9 times. And 2 goes into 30 15 times. All right. Let's try 2 again. Does 2 go into all three of these numbers? No, because I've got an odd number here, right? 9's odd, so no way. So what's the next prime number? 3. Does 3 go into all three numbers? Why, yes, it does. So you could put a 3 out here. 3 goes into 6 twice, 3 goes into 9 3 times, and 3 goes into 15 5 times. And these are all prime numbers at the end, so yeah, nothing except 1 is going to go into them. So at the end, I need to multiply those numbers together. 2 times 3 is the greatest common factor. Could somebody have done this a little bit differently? Absolutely. Again, let me make this just a little bit smaller. Here we go. That's how we did it one way. Let's do it again. So we have 12, 18, and 30. Somebody might have just said, hey, I noticed 6 goes into all those numbers, and they just divide by 6 right off the bat. 6 goes into 12 twice. 6 goes into 18, 3, and 6 goes into 35, and then they would have got it on one step. So there's only one number, so the greatest common factor is 6. And then, why not one more time? How about person number 3? When they looked at this, they thought, I can think of a number that goes into all three of them. It happens to be 3. That's okay. Any number that you could think of that goes into all of those numbers, you could put on the outside. But if you can't think of anything, start with 2 and then try 3 and then try 5, etc. So 3 goes into 12 4 times. 3 goes into 18 6 times. 3 goes into 30 10 times. Okay, now we look at these three numbers and we think, what goes into all three of those numbers? Is there any number that divides into all of those evenly? And that will be 2. So 2 goes into 4 twice, 2 goes into 6 3 times, 2 goes into 10 5 times. And again, we are just going to multiply those numbers together to get our answer. So there's three ways that three different students might figure out that the greatest common factor of 12, 18, and 30 is the number 6. All right, we'll do some more examples on the next video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.